reasons I despise carnies. People who consume the meat, dairy, eggs, silk or leather, wearing that, honey, and exploiting other animals. People who believe it is normal and natural, justifiable, just like slavery was once. According to the slave master mentality, or mythology. First, they deny the victims their rights. Have you ever heard that? Something like that goes in this way. Are there not our human beings? Do you know that slave masters also deny the rights of their slaves, and saying that they are just savages, barbarians, beasts, wilds, bondmen, uncivilized, not inhuman. Most of their, when they talk about slave masters, they talk about wives. If they are talking about cattle and chattel come both from the same word, both descended from the middle of Latin word capital, meaning property. You are not one human, in my opinion, if you are causing cruelty. Because the terminology humane connected with human, and if that being, then you are not one human if you are doing something inhumane. If you ask me, stop being so hypocritical douchebag, people. Yes, I called you people. That's what a word why I still use. Because it means actor's mask. It means you are a tool. You one being one part of one very big satire called this society. Second, they say stupid, annoying stuff like we need a protein to vegans. Do you think that flesh only have protein, animal flesh? Where do you think cows get the protein from? Where do you think gorillas get the protein from? Or rhinos? From plants. Any plant have protein. Even fruit have protein. Bananas, 5% protein. Blueberries, 7% protein. Stop being annoying, people. Stop playing asinine. People also say we have done it for centuries. You know, people have also eaten each other for centuries. So let me justify its cannibalism. I think you don't will do it either. It's a very bad excuse. Because we can use that to justify most things. People have also abused the children for centuries. So is that a justification? Of course not. And in reality, the first flesh humans eat are most likely the flesh of other humans, particular brains. Before a fire, there was no flesh eating. That's a fact. When people say, we have to care first about our species. Our class of species. You know, slave masters like to play the same game. Check out.
The poor and laboring classes of your own race and color, not only your fellow beings, but your fellow citizens, are more miserable and degraded, morally and physically, than our slaves. Rights of man, woman's rights, Negroism, etc., are eternally upon the lips of the abolitionists. But do they sympathize with the white laborer in his endeavors to improve his social condition?
Stop playing out annoying people. This, quite frankly, isn't civilized. We have to eliminate nationalism and tribalism and become earthlings instead of parasites. Going to one place, taking all the resources away from it, and then kill that piece of plants, just like people have done with a lot of parts of Australia. Turn it in deserts.
It's quite one thing.
Only one thing. Humans are different than other species. Or I mean, are different than other species. And that's the capacity of not living in harmony with the environment. The Homo nutus is the only species how do not live in symbiosis with his environment. He thinks he can control it. He thinks he can manipulate it. He thinks he is a shepherd, when in reality, the most of the time they are only doing damage control. Damage control is not stewardship, people. People say, we are more intelligent than other animals, therefore, is it justifiable? This kind of logic can also justify that scientists have the right to kill you. Most likely, because scientists have a higher IQ than you. This kind of so-called intelligence can be used to justify it. Also, racial discrimination. Because, according to statistics, people in Africa have a lower IQ than people in the West. And Asian people have the highest IQ of all. So, that we then rule the whole world by Chinese people? Now, not so good idea, if you ask me. This so-called intelligence can be used to make the whole world worse for anybody. And if you ask me, intelligence is, in my opinion, the capacity of an organism to live in harmony with its environment, in contrast with destroying anything around them, destroying multitudes of life forms only because of greedy, selfish traditions, beliefs, and habits. It is pure and honest asinine. So, above the excuses you use, Saying plants can suffer. So, vegans cost also pay because they're causing plants to suffer. Are you serious? Plants have no central nervous system, people. So they are not can feel a pain. When organisms have don't need one central nervous system to feel pain. Without one working central nervous system, your brain don't get signs that get hurt. And that's the difference between plants. That's one of the main difference between plants and other life forms on this planet. But I have also not heard from somebody who make up some organization of protecting the carrots of the world. Or broccoli deserve absolute protection today and tomorrow. And why? Because broccoli, bananas, rice, are insentient commodities. They're not going to feel pain. In contrary with animals, who suffer extremely in these places of horror you make excuses for. This 2018. Give it up. It is not quite a fun. If there is a victim in the scenario, then it is not longer your choice.
Oh, it's vegans! They're placing their public relation and their games on me. Oh, they forced a lifestyle on me.
Vegans don't force a lifestyle on you. Why? Because there is a victim in your scenario, and so you force your lifestyle on this animal. You also force your lifestyle on people in poor countries who die from starvation. Because something like 50% to 70% of all the food is fed to livestock. We can easily feed the whole world. The only thing that has happened is that people have to stop being elitist pricks and stop abusing animals because of traditional beliefs and habits. So we can here in this scenario be not the person who forced their lives on others. Because we, the vegans, are coming up for the victims of systematic exploitation. The victimizer have no right to complain about anything. You have no right to complain because you know supply and demand. You pay, you are responsible. You can change. And stop saying, you can maybe change, but you have to respect my choices. Because rapists also use that, and Nazis, they say, I respect your choice to not do that, but you have my right, you have to respect my right to exploit. That's what Nazis say. That's what rapists say. That's what slave masters say. That's what Ku Klux Klan members say.
Be the sin, the danger, and evils of slavery all our own. We compel, we ask none to share them with us.
You know, the only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing. Because the evil people take what they want. They take the victims, they abuse them, that torture them. Later, you stand behind saying, please let the victims go, please let the victims go, please let the victims go. Make the world not a better place. Victimizers, for the victimizer, it is easy to put a stop away. What do you think that the majority of white people say when white people want to get their rights? Something like that?
Boo! They're just whites, and they're just blacks. So why do they think they deserve rights at all? We are white, we are more special than none. I think you deserve any rights at all. What do the blacks think? That you have getting adjusted to ask much from us? Maybe we think about it. It's all nice to us.
Same thing with sexists.
They're just wrong, you know? They're just wrong, they're not like us, they're wicked in us. They're blessed. They're taller, they are less than us. They are less intelligent.
Stop playing that asinine fill in the blank game, people. Because if you are in the victim's position, you don't like the way they talk and you don't like the way they act. This is the victimizer's mindset that is wrong, not the of the eliminationists, the abolitionists, the revolutionaries in this kind of way. You are not supposed to be so full with patriotism that you are not can face reality. Wrong is wrong. No matter how say it or how do it. Peace begins on the dinner table by what you eat on one daily basis. Good people don't talk only about morality, kindness, and compassion. They actually give it on a daily basis.